If you think that clouds are just a static background, you're missing one of the most revolutionary features of the new version of Twinmotion. Managing clouds is super easy. The first thing you need to know is that clouds can only be managed with Dynamic Sky, since with the HDRI background, the clouds are already included within the HDRI image. Choosing whether to use 2D or volumetric clouds is up to you, but I strongly recommend using 3D ones for better angling and quality. Move the first slider to increase the amount of clouds in the scene and use the second to define their height. The appearance menu is related to aesthetics of the clouds. In fact, you can change their size with scale, you can change their size vertically with the vertical extent command, make them flat at the base by changing the flat bottom slider, and with the puffiness command you can adjust the silhouette and make them more or less defined. In addition to this, you can change the color of all the clouds, simulating rainy or very cloudy days, but most importantly you can intervene in the density. But I'll come back to that shortly. To top it off, you can also create cirrus positioned above the main clouds banks, regardless of whether or not you have created the volumetric clouds. In the distribution menu instead, you can decide which portion of the sky will be characterized by the presence of clouds, in particular with the command radial dissipation and directional dissipation. With the first one, by modifying the intensity and the radius of action, we will create in the sky a radial zone in which there will be no clouds. The center of the radius is our position in the viewport of Twinmotion. In fact, moving in the space, the radial center will move with me. Modify consequently the sky. With the second one instead, I identify an area of sky where there is a greater concentration of clouds, which, combined with the parameters in the appearance menu, allows us to simulate the classic sky where, on the horizon, a storm is predicted to arrive. Finally, again from this menu, we can activate the checkbox on affected by wind and set their respective speed factor. 1 means that the clouds will move at the speed of the wind, 2 will go at twice the speed, 3 at 3 times the speed, and so on. By activating the wind from the corresponding menu, the volumetric clouds will start to move, giving you the possibility to create more and more realistic videos. When I use this type of clouds, I always set an intermediate presence, tending towards cloudy, a height of a couple of thousand meters, a good percentage of cirrus, puffiness to the maximum and scaling to taste. But the most important thing for me is to set the position of the sun right away to define how the natural lights will integrate the design and consequently make the clouds obscure. In case I fail on the first attempt, after setting the various parameters, I change the random seed, a very convenient command to randomize the clouds in the sky with respect to the set parameters until a composition is generated in which the sun is obscure. It is me who decides how much the sun will or will not be obscured by the clouds, which is crucial to manage the behavior of sunlight on the project. To do this, I use the density slider. The less the clouds are dense, the more net sunlight will pour on the project. The more the clouds are dense, the less direct sun I will have in the project. This way, I can decide for myself whether or not to have net beams of sunlight or not. Finally, any composition you create can be saved as a template and used in a future project. Or you can use the one already created by the Twinmotion team. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future content. Like the video so you can help me with the algorithm. And suggest me in the comment what topics you would like me to cover in the next video. That said, I wish you a good day or evening and see you very, very soon. Ciao!